So today I'm going to discuss with you the
analytical balance, the beam balance or the weighing balance. So see carefully the various components of this analytical balance. This is how it looks. And to begin with, we have adjustment screws at the bottom of this. If I move these screws either clockwise or anti-clockwise, the level is going to either move up or down. The purpose of these screws is to make it properly horizontal on a surface on which we are making measurements, right? Because every surface might not be absolutely flat. So just to set that, to take that leveling component to adjust, we have the adjustment screws here. So we have these two adjustment screws. We have a screw here and we have a screw here, and this is the main knob, which when moved, you can see this pointer is going to move either towards left or towards right when I move this rotating knob. This knob, when we move in the clockwise direction, the pointer here is also going to move, right? So before we begin, it's important to adjust this to zero value. Zero value means when the entire analytical balance is balanced. So here I have one window to this balance. This side is another window, and this is front window which can open or close. And this line that you can see here, this is called the plumb line. And before I start to weigh anything, I have to make this plumb line vertical in sync with this point here. Okay, this is called plumb line. And now this is the beam. This is the beam, and the various components of this beam I'm removing and showing to you. This loop can be removed, and then I can remove this part. This loop can be removed. So you can read R on this, which means this is the right hand pan. This is the pan on which we are going to put weights. So I am now going to put this back. Similarly, children, I have another pan on this also. L will be marked here. That means this is the left hand pan. On this we are going to place the substance to be weighed. And if you see carefully, here are some screws. This screw, if moved inside or outside, helps in the small adjustments of making both these pans in balance. And this part is the beam, and this is the part where we are going to pick up a rider and place a rider. So this can be moved. This is the rider scale on which we are going to place a rider to make minor adjustments in mass. In the center we have the zero here, and it goes from 0 to 10 this side, and similarly on the other side also the points read from 0 to 10. We are going to start our measurement. So I'm going to make adjustments from here to make this plumb line in line with the pointer below. For this, the screw here is going to be turned both the sides. I'm moving this screw in the clockwise direction, and you can see the plumb line has come in line with the pointer below. Okay, so to begin with, this part has to be checked. Next, I'm going to just move this center knob in the clockwise direction. You can see the central needle is moving towards right. That means the right side pan is a little lighter. The side to which this needle moves is the lighter side. So I'm going to make this adjustment from this side. I will be moving this screw till this becomes balanced. Now, I moved this side screw a little outside. That added weight to it. And the left hand side screw I moved a little inside. So now let us check this pointer. And remember, the pointer has to be seen exactly in line with the reading, so that there's no parallax error. Now it's moving exactly to the same extent to both the directions. That means either it shouldn't be static. It becomes static sometimes when it gets stuck. So it should move, but it should move slightly and equally towards both directions, or it should be exactly in line with the zero point. So here our balance is ready to take the measurements, right? And now I want to measure a quantity 1.26 gram, for which I'm going to use this weight box. And this is a forcep. This forcep is used to pick up these weights. We should not touch the weights, because touching will soil the weights and can affect their original weight. This is 1 gram. These are 2 gram each. This is 5 gram, 10, 20, 50 and 100. And then we have a fractional weight box. This is a fractional weight box. And in this we have different shapes of weights. Like this, you can see is a hexagon, a hexagonal shape weight, which is 500 milligram. Different shapes will help you to identify these weights more easily. We have a rectangular 200 milligram weight, okay. And then there is a triangular weight, which is 100 milligram. This is triangular, this is 100 milligram. Now see carefully, this one is a 500 milligram weight. You can see it is hexagonal in shape, and a smaller hexagon is 50 milligram. And this original weight box had weights in grams. This is a fractional weight box with weights in milligram, 500, 50. This is 200, 200 and 20. A smaller with the same shape, rectangular shape, 20. This is triangular, this is 100. And this is a smaller triangle, this is 10 milligram, right? And similarly, this loop, this is called a rider. This rider, when placed on the rider scale, is going to add 1 to 10 milligram of mass. So this is the loop. When we place this on the rider scale, whichever point we place it at the rider scale, suppose I keep it on the 5 milligram point, this is going to add 5 milligram to that side. Like if I place this rider, let us suppose I place it here. So if this point reads 3 milligram, it means it is going to add 3 milligram towards this side, towards this span. So this is basically required for very finer measurements, finer adjustments. And I want to weigh a 2.26 gram quantity. So towards the right hand side, I'm placing a 2 gram weight. 2.26 gram means 2 gram, 260 milligram. Then I'm picking up a 200 milligram weight, and now I'm picking a 100 milligram weight, adding it here, and then 50 milligram weight. So this is 2 gram, 350 milligram, that is 2.35 gram weight I have added towards the right hand side. And now I'm going to add the salt towards the left hand side. I will close this side of window before I start and add the weight on the other side. Now the other side, I will be adding weight either on a glazed paper or on a watch glass. So I'm going to weigh this watch glass first, placing watch glass towards the left hand pan, closing both the windows, and now I will move this knob towards clockwise direction, and I can see the pointer goes towards the right hand side pan. That means the right hand side pan is lighter. So I'll just close this, bring the pointer to zero position, and approximately I'm going to add this 20 gram weight. This is still lighter. That means I need to add more. So I'm going to add 10 gram more. Now it is more. I'll be adding 5 gram. I've added 5 gram. Let us check again. Now this is also more, so I will remove this and instead try with 2 gram. This is also less. Add a 1 gram weight. Yeah. So now this is already 20 gram plus 1 gram, and now I'm going to make the last measurement using a milligram weight. I've added 500 milligram more. So this is still light. the pointer is not moving, right? That means the balance has been balanced. The weight of watch glass is decided. So I'm simply going to add up all these weights. So this is a 20 gram weight plus 121. Let us count all the milligram weights. This is 500 plus 200 plus 100, 850 gram. So 21 gram, 850 milligram is the weight of watch glass. And now I want to weigh a 2 gram salt. I want to weigh 2 gram salt. So I'm adding 2 gram weight here. And now I'm going to add the compound on the other side. So we've added the required weights. Now I'll be adding salt to the other side. So now I'm adding this side. The pointer you can see is moving towards left. That means more amount of the salt needs to be added. So now I'm slowly adding this salt till the pointer reaches the zero mark. You must close the windows and see that no salt is sticking to the base of the watch glass. You must perform your experiment very neatly. So it's almost done. I bring the knob back to zero position. And once again, I softly move it in the clockwise direction and check. See, the pointer has come to zero. So this is the weight of 2 gram weight of the salt has been measured. So I'm going to simply now pick this up and make a standard solution. How to make a standard solution, I have a complete video. I'll be posting the link at the base, so you can check that to complete this experiment, how to do weighing and then make a standard solution of a given salt. So in case you need any such videos on any specific topic, kindly post in the comment section, and do like, share and subscribe.